Hey people, greetings Paul Muckle here. Today is December 26th, 2011. What time is it? It's 5 o'clock. 5:10 PM Eastern Time. I hear that star and guess what? We have company. The moon. There they go. The moon and the star. Yeah, people, look at how big the moon is though. The quarter moon is huge. I could see the other, it's a super quarter moon. I could see the other part of it. Okay, here they go. Someone sent me a message, said this is Venus. I don't know what it could be. It's just after sunset. And people, the moon, right, appear out of nowhere all of a sudden, right? Just like the star appeared, so did the moon. Because yesterday, I was looking out and the moon wasn't there. The day before yesterday, I filmed it and the moon wasn't there. You see the plane coming down next to the moon with the chemtrail? Right here. See right there? Coming out with this chemtrail. I don't know if y'all can see the chemtrail behind it.
Okay people, I'm gonna use the rest of my time right to show you all some very important information, especially you YouTube uploaders and those of you who are doing YouTube, revenue sharing. People, on December 24th right, I upload part 1 of this video. I'm gonna show y'all what YouTube did to part 1 of this video, okay? And y'all really need to listen up. Look at this people right. On December 25th right people, this video had 464 views, right? And December 25th, 464 views, right? But look at this, people. Look. But when I go to my video manager, it only tells me the same video, breaking news, a huge new morning star in the west, interpretation of pyramid text. In my, look at it, people, see the time? 9:23 Christmas Day, and one screen he said had 464 views, but in this screen he said how I've only 304 views, right? Look at it, people. Now, and December 26th at 10:50 a.m. the same video, look at it, 501 views, people. 501 views, right? Clearly 501 views. Okay, when I go to my video manager, look at this. I go to my video manager, the same video. Okay. It's telling me I have still have 304 views. Okay. December 26th at 10:50 a.m. My video manager is telling me I have 304 views. 9 thumbs up. Okay, now people, watch this. Watch this. The only way I could see those views, I have to look at another video and it appear right next to the other video. You see where I get my views? See right now? When it appear to the next video, that's when I see the true views. 501 views. Okay? Otherwise, I won't know how many views it got. Then people on December 27th, now at 12:35 a.m. Look at this. 304. You see, people, first was five, a few hours ago, you had 501 view. 501 views, people. Now all of a sudden, it's 304. The same thing you've been stuck on since December 25th. Okay, people? And you know when it happened, people, after YouTube did their updating users account, when they update our views, that's when they did it. They deleted 197 views from my video. And for what, people? What are they afraid of? These pigs at YouTube and Google, these Rothschilds, these Zionist pigs. And no, Zionist is not a racial slur, it's a group. You Zionist pigs, that's what y'all doing to us, okay? Censoring us, stealing us, robbing our views, you pigs. And people, it's not even the video they're afraid of, it's not the start video. They're not afraid of the first 3 minutes of the video, they're afraid of the last 10 minutes. The interpretation of the pyramid text, because I show you what the Zionists are all about. It exposed them. So they're blocking my video, deleting the views, people. Deleting the views. This is what they're afraid of. People, I'm going to show it to you all again, okay? Watch this, people. Interpretation of the pyramid text, people. You all need to pay attention, people.
Hey, people. I'm going to use this opportunity, right, to tell you all what I've been figuring out, right? People, right? This figure here that you're seeing, right? It's a statue of it's a Greek statue, a Roman statue, right? It is supposed to be a statue of the morning star and the evening star. It also represents the sun and the moon, night and day. The ability to see in the future and in the past. The ability to see danger before it comes. Okay? So which to me is the face of God, the all-seeing eyes of God. You can see in the future and in the past. Okay? In the front and in the back. Now people, as you all can see, one face is light and one face is dark. This is also means God and the devil. People, the devil is not evil. The devil just means the dead. Okay, or the deceased, okay? Lived. Turn devil around and you spell lived. Okay? So the devil is supposed to be Osiris. Because he once lived, I know he's dead. So he lived. And the Egyptians used to write and spell from left to right. Sorry people, quick correction here. The Egyptians did not read or write from their left to the right. They actually read and write from their right to the left. So it was the Romans, the shepherd kings, who came and changed things around. The Romans who changed things around and had to start reading and writing from the left to the right. But the Egyptians did it from the right to the left. That's why they're so confused. That's why they don't know what pyramid text means, because they're reading it wrong. Okay, that's why. So when the Rothschild came and conquered Egypt, the shepherd kings came and conquered Egypt, what they did was they started reading the language, the pyramid text, from right to left and confused everything. Okay, so in the translation they did the same thing. So there's no such thing as devil, and there's no such thing as God. Devil means lived, and God is dog. Okay, that's all it is. So don't let people trick you. So anyway, what I'm trying to say, people, is that this statue here signify what I said. And the proof is, people, and the Egyptian pharaoh head, right? What's on the Egyptian pharaoh head? He have a serpent and a phoenix. Okay, the bird and the snake. Now, people, if you put a bird and a snake together, what would happen? The serpent would eat the bird. Will eat it. They are mortal enemies. Just like you say, God and the devil. Okay? God and the devil. So, the man was created for one purpose, right? Man was created to unite who? God and the devil. As one, because people, without God and the devil, there's no existence. It's a counterbalance. The devil is a counterbalance in an ordinary universe. Okay? God needs the devil needs God, because they counter each other. Without one, the other one gonna collapse. So anyway, the proof is people. Okay, people look at a light bulb, right? In a wire, you have a positive wire and a negative wire. Black wire, white wire, positive, negative, right? Now, if you look at a light switch, when you turn the light switch on, right, you have two separate wires, right? The wire goes where? Up to the light bulb, right? And when they reach the tip of the light bulb, what we get? We get light. Two dangerous sources uniting one to create light, harmony. Now, if in between those wires, if you cut those wires and you touch them, what you get? You get a short circuit, right? You get a short circuit. So the only place God and the devil can meet is where? At a place of unity in man. Okay, so no, I forget to tell people's spirit, the body of man was created to contain God and the devil, to contain them in harmony, because God and the devil is always at odds with each other, because they counter each other, and that's what it's supposed to be. And but they wanted peace, they wanted to unite, because they realized, listen man, we work together, so we work in harmony together, but we can't touch each other. If we touch each other, it's going to be short circuit, it's going to be flames and sparks and destruction. But we need each other. So how are we going to overcome that? Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. And in them, in those men, we will unite. In man, we will unite as one. And through man, we'll be able to control the storms, control the evil, the violence. True man will be able to control that. So the body was created, people, to what? To imprison the soul of God and the devil. The body was created to imprison that. But man has been tricked into allowing the serpent and the bird, which is God and the devil, to imprison him. Okay? They control us. They die. They could kill us anytime they want to kill us. We have no silver. But yet they created us to contain them. So now instead of the body being the prison for the soul, instead of the body being made to contain the soul is now controlling the body. And that's why people die and get sick, because the devil or the evil aspect of us causes to use drugs that destructive, you know, destructive stuff. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make, people, the proof, right, is in the Egyptian Pharaoh head. Okay, on his head he have the serpent and the rainbow. In his hand he have the rod and the staff, God and the devil. And in man, they're supposed to unite. In man. Okay, it also, the serpent is also the moon. And the phoenix is the sun. Okay, the sun and the moon together. That's how man came to the sun and the moon. Okay, that's how we was created, by the powers of the sun and the moon. How they did it, I don't know. That will come later on. But the proof right here is in the Pharaoh's head. And these other pictures, people, I didn't fake these pictures. One day I was just messing over the camera. I had the camera in front of my face, holding the camera and just letting it roll. And when I went downstairs and put it in my computer, I seen the sun in my head and this thing in my eye. I swear to you, I didn't even know it was there, people. I did not know it was there when I was taking the film. I did not know. If I knew it was there, I probably wouldn't have came out like that. I was just fooling around. I said, let me see what's gonna happen if I put this camera in my face. And I turned towards the sun, I turned my back to the sun, and I put a camera in my face, and that's what you see. I didn't fake anything. So anyway, these pictures, they're significant, take it for what it means. I'm not trying to prove anything, I'm just trying to show you all how it is, okay? So take it how y'all want to take it, but there's strange things going on, people. Okay? Like I said again, the serpent and the rainbow signify God and the devil, and it means that in them, in man, they are supposed to be united in one, as one, one love.